Welcome to the second part of point cloud video. If you already watched the first part of this video, then you remember that we create a point cloud from a 3D object, and we put a base and we copied all our node inside the base, which is our point cloud component that now in this video we want to learn how to customize this component. So let's start. First thing that I did here is that I changed the base that I put like all the parameter for my points. I changed the name to points. And here in my point cloud components, I add output. And I will go one step back and I add a null because I want to see my visual in the background. So here I right click on my base, and there's a option customize components. Click on that, so you will see this window. The first part is where you can add a page. Now here I add a page, I call it point. I will on the other side, I will go inside the other base that I have, which contains my point. On the second part of this window, I write noise and I choose header because I want to make it a bit organized. And from the noise, I want to be able to have access to period, to exponent, and to amplitude, so I will add them inside my components. But just remember that you should change the header to floats when you glitch here. And you can see there are like too many options, but if you want to have like numbers, you should choose floats. And as you can see, you on the bottom side, you have access to the minimum range, maximum range, and your default range. So for each one of these parameters, you can decide what is your minimum number and what is your maximum number. Now you can see these three options that I choose are already added to my page. Now how can we connect like these parameters to the parameters that are inside? If you right click on, for example, period here, you can choose copy parameter, and inside your base, you can click on the period on your nodes, right click on it and paste the references. Now you can see that if I, even I change the period outside, my period inside is changing. So this is one way to do it. Now I just delete this expression, and I want to show you another way which is somehow more useful, and I prefer that. Another way that we can do it is that we go to chop, we go inside our base and we go to chop and we choose parameter. And now you can see already all the parameters that we created for our base are inside this node. What I do after parameter, I add a filter and I add a node. And now I want to use this null, which is after the filter, instead of direct copying the value. So here I just I right click on my null and I use vortex because I want to go again inside another base, and I don't want to like make more like line connection to put one input and connect it. So I just use vortex and I go inside. And I drag and drop each channel to each to every parameters that they are meant to be connected. What filter does in this connection is that it makes the movement a bit more smooth, because if you are like playing live and you are just going from one number to another, then it's always nice to have like some smoothness than just going like very sharp and direct. you can decide like whatever you want to add inside your component. For example, here I add like my LFO frequency. I want to have access to the speed of the movement of this white line that is yellow on my point cloud. And so I add the frequency here. I've also put a header, which I call it effect. And you can easily change the order of your parameters in your component editor by dragging and dropping like each parameter up and down. But it's really up to you what name you want to use and how do you want to divide your component into different pages or into different sections. I also add another parameter in my component, which is a switch, because as you remember, we put a switch between the feedback and before the feedback, and so I want to be able also to switch between them. I again go to my component editor. I want to add a file because for this component I want to be able to change my 3D model if I want, and that makes it easier to have it outside instead of always going inside to change your file. So for this one, I right click and I copy parameter and I paste the references inside my point file in the file section. We also have a switch between our cubes and our pointer spirits. I want to also add this option to my component, so I put a menu and I call it box point. Here we have three numbers, but since we just have two options, I delete one of them. And here you can change the names. I call the label 2 point and label 1 box. Now you can see we have a menu here that we can choose if we want to have boxes or if you want to have a pointer spirit. I assign the switch to the switch inside my geometry between boxes and pointer spirit. And for this I also copy the parameter and I don't use the one with filter. And here I paste the reference. Now we can see it changing. But one more thing that I need to do with this switch is that I should assign this switch also to my material. Because as you remember, for boxes we needed a material that is for 3D object, and for pointer spirit we needed the pointer spirit material. So here if when I switch, it switch like at the same time the geometry and the material. Another parameter that I add to my component is box size. Always remember to choose float when you are adding something that has value. always be careful when you are working with point pillars and you are using like boxes or a sphere for your points. Always be careful with the size, because if the size gets like very big, there's a possibility that your software crash. So here I don't put like very high value for my boxes size. And for this, instead of direct scoping, I use the null that I have inside after my filter. Now I have all the parameters that I wanted so far to have access to them to make like changes. All these parameters can be also interactive with sound or with anything. And that makes it way easier when you have a component and you have like all these parameters that you want from, like all these notes that are inside, every time that you have to go for each one of them to change something. But if you put everything that you want here, you can just very nicely customize it for your use. Now here I add another page, I call it camera. I want to kind of separate my points from like my camera, but you can also put everything in one page, it really depends on you. And I add a rotation, a translate, and I choose float. But as you can see here, instead of this, it was number 1, the next option that I had, but I choose 3, because I have 3 numbers for my camera translate that I want to change. And now here I have the 3 of them, and I assign like each one of these to my camera. Now when I change the translate C of my camera, which is kind of zooming in and zooming back, you can see it's I can do it from a component. Now you can see that I add numbers to my filter bits. I put it on 3, and then you can see when I change the camera, my camera is moving like much more slower and much more smooth than just a sudden, very sudden movement that zoom in and zoom back. So you can play around with this filter also a lot. You can add as many parameters as you want to your component. It really depends on what you want to change and for what reason actually you want to use them. And there are like, as you saw that in your component editor, you have like too many options. You can even add colors. You can even have access to change the color of your point cloud here. And this little bit, it's not really specified for point cloud. It's like whatever you do, whatever touch that you make, you can put it in one base and you can customize it like this. And I think it's a very good feature that Touch Designer has that helps you to organize your file and also use, like, you don't have to every time make, if you want to make a point cloud, you don't have to every time go and make all these patches from the start. So you have some basic parameters here that you can add your new files, you can add your new 3D file, and based on your 3D file, you can decide which parameters you want to use, which parameters you want to add or you want to remove. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and it was helpful for you. I will be back with more videos. I will upload more videos. Please subscribe if you want to get notified.